Hi guys, welcome to Simproved, Fry speaking here, and welcome back to another Sims 4 speed build. This time it's on a Sunday because it is the speed build for my upcoming challenge let's play called The Island. And therefore, I'm building a tropical island. Who would have thought? Yeah, it's pretty cool. It's super detailed. I love it. And you can also use it if you want to do the challenge with me together. And yeah, the only basic idea of this whole build is to build like an island surrounded by a pool, of course, because yeah, you can't like use tarantulas or something in The Sims 4 yet. And your Sims can live there and live on a tropical island. So the basic idea I had is I want to have an island with a volcano, and then after I've like thought about having a volcano, I also wanted to have a cave. So I'm going to do both on this island, and that's why there is this room, put an archway in there, also put a stairs to the side so they can like later the Sims can get to the volcano and climb on the volcano. And then I build a pool for the not bottom level, but it's like the same level as the room. And later on, because with get together, I guess we got new colors for the pool, and I used of course the red color so it looks a little bit like lava. Or lava? I guess you say lava. Do you pronounce it lava in English? I guess so. I mean, we do in German too, so I will use lava right now. It's lava. Lava. Lava, lava, lava. But yeah, this is what I did here. That was like the basic idea. And then after I've done that, I stacked lots and lots of these outdoor retreat tables. I guess it's supposed to be tables and chair from outdoor retreat that look like stones. And they are fantastic to stack stuff. So I've used them in my alienation house, in my alien house. I've used them, when did I use them again? In my lake cabins a lot. So if I'm like building like a mountain-y structure or a cliff of some sorts, I will always use them because they're easier to stack. They look prettier when, yeah, put together, like in my, for my taste. Subjective, of course. Yeah, that's why I use them a lot. I think they look pretty cool. That's like one reason that getting outdoor retreat as a pack paid off for me as builder, because I got these items and they're pretty easy for stacking all that stuff. So yeah, you can already see how it all forms. So first I also did, like I said, room and pool, and then the stairs, then like trying to make it look as a mountain of some sorts, and then later on I will stack like lots and lots of plants in there. Of course, like everything that looks tropical, so there will like be some bamboo, some palm trees, lots of not ferns, but it's like I guess some kind of fern. Some of the more tropical looking flowers, so I guess they were from the romantic garden stuff pack, but I'm not sure. So yeah, I've used like all packs that I have, and I have no idea how it will look like for you in the end if you are lacking like one pack, because I can't remember which one has like which kind of object. But if you are doing the challenge, for example, you don't necessarily have to use this lot, but maybe it can be like a nice inspiration for you. And yeah, let me talk about the challenge that I made up. It's always coming up on Sunday now. I will play the challenge. I've invented the challenge, so to speak. And it's called the Island Challenge. It's kinda like the Castaway Challenge that's already like it exists in the Sims 4 challenge universe. But with kind of a twist, because sometimes you have to roll two dice to have something like special events happening to your sim. And I thought that would be really, really interesting and changing like on a higher level that you yourself can't really influence the game. And yeah, making like decisions for you so you don't have to make them. And I thought it would be really, really cool. And also I will put everything, like all the rules about the challenge, down below in the video descriptions. Like there will be some links, and I've already have to thank so many people, because a lot of people have helped me for playtesting this, because I'm currently on vacation, as you all know. And yeah, I sadly don't have so much time to test or like play The Sims because I'm, yeah, even now I actually don't have time to do this voiceover, but I sneaked like to my laptop and do it like in a secret now because I really wanted to get that video out. So I have to thank all my testers for the challenge, which is Wahisha, Less Than Zero Sims, and Celine. Those three have also YouTube accounts and I will link them down below. Really nice simmers and my friends, and you have to check them out. Also a friend of me, but not with a YouTube account, is Belle Guru. She's like a really avid sim Twitterer, I guess it's called, yeah. And she also tested and she had like the most ideas how to be more specific in the rules, and she thought about every detail and everything. So I want to thank her so, so much. And yeah, I've also spammed all those people already with thank you notes. But I'm also, of course, doing this in this video again. And I also want you guys to check them out because they're all really nice people and they love to sim just like me. And yeah, that's like my hobby and it's their hobby, and therefore we all like each other, I guess. Like, it brings people together, the whole game. So yeah, the whole challenge, I guess I will like more explain it in detail when I really do the let's play, which comes like every Sunday right now, but I wanted to start with a build. Yeah, that's what I usually always do. I'm like a build mode person, and you guys want to see like mostly speed builds. So yeah, I thought it would be like a cool start, and if this slot gets you interested into the challenge, then yeah, sure, do the challenge. If you have no idea what I'm talking about because you don't play The Sims ever and just, I don't know, watch my videos because I'm such a derpy, lovable person, I have no idea why you actually do it then, but yeah, glad you do. And if you enjoy them, of course, hey, happy times. I'm super happy to make you happy. But yeah, I will explain it to you, because in The Sims you don't have like real quests or goals in the game. It's like playing with puppets somehow, like with dolls. You have to imagine your own little ideas for the game and how to, you know, you have to set your own goals. So you can like say, yeah, I want to have them to level up all their skills, or and I have to, I don't know, like reach that career goal or something. I mean, you can do that in game, but after a while maybe it gets a little bit boring or you just want to do something else. And that's why people invent challenges for The Sims 4. For example, like, I guess like the most known one is like the 100 baby challenge, which is like self-explanatory, I guess, having 100 babies with one sim. Also, rags to riches, from being super poor to being like a millionaire, for example. There's like also very specific challenges, but since I'm like I've never played one single challenge, to be honest, so I can't really tell you what else there is. Just type in into Google challenges Sims 4 and you will get like lots and lots of stuff. And I always wanted to build like on an island where the Sims can't leave the lot. I don't know why, but I thought it would be cool if they were stranded, and I googled it, so there was this castaway challenge, but it wasn't like as detailed for me and kind of boring somehow. I mean, I don't want to offend anyone that created the castaway challenge, but I thought you could do so much more with an island. And since your Sims are like not leaving the lot, you have to make it super, super interesting, like the challenge, because you can't like visit with your Sims like a theater or museum or whatever, or even friends, because they can't leave the lot or can't leave the island. You have to make it super interesting and have some action on the island. So I thought, yeah, that would be cool if you could use some dice, and the sum of the dice tell you what happens every day. So you have to roll two dice. If you don't have two dice at your home and want to play that challenge, there's always a phone app that will help you out. I've actually even looked at my app. Well, like, I've looked up for Android how many apps there are, and I personally counted 21 dice rolling apps. So I guess there are enough out there. So if you don't have any dice, there's an app for that. and I will use them in my challenge, for example, too. And yeah, sometimes the dice tell you that your sims, for example, get skill points, and sometimes the dice tell you that one sim dies, for example. You have to kill them. And that makes it intriguing, I guess. You want to know what happens and you roll the dice and just hope that nobody dies and that you get like a nice outcome of the dice roll. But there are also bad things that can happen and that you absolutely have to execute. Otherwise, yeah, don't cheat. I mean, that's always in all challenges, I guess. You can't cheat. Just don't cheat. Come on, guys. It's super easy. Yeah, just trust in the dice and all the calculations and preparing I did and testing that it's absolutely doable. So the goal of the challenge is, because you start with two sims there, is to have at the end 8 adult or young adult and up sims. And they have to perform a ritual of some sorts, and then the island and the fate of island is free. The whole story is down below in the rules. So there are basically two gods living there. One is like the evil volcano god, therefore I have a volcano there. He's evil, he always wants offerings and, you know, he seeks attention a lot and therefore sends some disasters to your sims because they are disturbing him on the island. And then there's the good god that is actually you. You are the player, you're the good god, and you can control the sims and want that they flourish and reach their full potential. And yeah, so like the new era breaks on, I guess you say, for the island, that it's like habitable for your sims and that maybe at the end it's like a little village or some sort. So that was like the basic idea, and it's absolutely doable. It works. Your sims can survive there, and also one of the roles to roll the dice is that some sims will actually be added, will be washed ashore. So you don't even have like one family living there. At the end you can have multiple families living there, or some singles and all that stuff. It's going to be really, really interesting, and I hope that the rules are, yeah, specific enough for all those who have The Sims 4. I hope you like it, guys. It's lots of fun, the challenge, and I surely will fail a lot in my challenge during my let's play, but yeah, that's just who I am. I mean, I'm much more of a builder, but I thought that would be really interesting because, you know, just having 100 babies is just not cutting it for me. It's not super interesting for me. But yeah, if you are like into all that stuff, check out all the amazing challenges that people have created for The Sims. Simmers are super creative people. It's amazing what they come up with. I mean, there even are like mods and CC for them. There are challenges for them. There's like, I don't know, like tons of stuff out there in this huge community. And I sometimes like sit there and think, yeah, and I'm just building. I'm like doing nothing else than just building. I mean, like not even like thinking about pushing it more outward, like testing something else. Maybe I like it, I don't even know. And that's why I created the challenge, so I'm like forced to do more complicated gameplay, I would say. But yeah, I think it will be lots of fun and it will fail a lot. So if you're into that, stick around every Sunday at 6 p.m. German time. There will be a new episode of The Island. And yeah, that's basically it. On the island will be some fruit trees, so your sims can live off those trees. And also there was a fishing ground that I have got from debug mode, and they can really fish there. And also there are like a bunch of twigs, because I created actually like a crafting system that your sims can use, so they can get more furniture and make the whole island more habitable. And I'm looking forward to it if that is like all working out. I at least want to have two huts at the end with, you know, enough beds for 8 sims and enough food and all that stuff. So this is, will get like really interesting, and I hope it will work and that we have some luck with rolling the dice. And oh, I want to tell you about the basic idea of the build. Of course, there's a pool all around it, and I've seen that for the castaway challenge, like lots of people have just like put a pool in there, so the lot is rectangular with water, and I thought that looks odd somehow, just having like a pool and then it ends and then they can get out there, they can actually get from that lot. So I needed to, yeah, put like lots of stones and mountains around. So they're in an enclosure of the island, so they can relieve a lot. And also, I wanted it to look like more of a board game somehow, from like, if you look from the bird view, from the top view, it looks like a board game. And that was like the main idea, because you are like rolling the dice. I thought it would be fun to make it also look like board game somehow. Also, the surrounding mountains will, of course, have lots of plants, so it really looks tropical, like a tropical enclosure. And I think it looks cool. Also, there will be some shores, so there will be the fruit trees and all other stuff that you can maybe explore later on. I will also use, or like I have used, the Forgotten Grotto and the Sylvan Blade. I guess it's called. For those who don't know what I'm talking about, there are hidden worlds in The Sims 4. Sixsim, for example, is one of them, the alien planet that you get from Get to Work. And your Sims always have to master some kind of skill, or have to use like certain kind of objects with a certain amount of skill to get to these hidden worlds, or like hidden lots. So there is a more of a fairy tale lot, and there's like a Forgotten Grotto. And those two entries I've also put there on the island. I haven't tested those ones, but they will work. I mean, the grotto, I've used the grotto, they can get into the grotto, but I haven't used the Sylvan Blades one. But just assuming because the grotto works, the Sylvan Blades one will also work. So you can, of course, if you do the challenge, like visit these kinds of lots, because there are like no neighbors there. You're always alone if you go to that kind of lot. And yeah, I just thought it would be like suiting for the whole theme. So maybe you can at least like visit these kinds of lots or like worlds. It's always fun to explore more things. So that's also there. And here's some fruit trees and the twigs for the crafting. Your Sims can pick them up just normally in game mode. You can also drop or drag and drop them into their inventory, like everything they can have in their inventory. And then with the twigs, there will be the table in the rules. With a certain amount of twigs, you, for example, your Sims can craft a bed, and therefore you go to build mode and like get your bed, and they have crafted it, and then of course sell the amount of twigs that you use for the bed. So this is how the crafting system works, because you are not allowed to, you know, buy them luxury stuff and just put a villa in there. I mean, that's not the basic idea of the challenge. I have to survive there, of course. So yeah, that's basically it. I've like overly decorated and cluttered it, but I also tried not to use too many stones again, because I know that some of you don't have the best PCs. I don't have the best PC, but it was really working here, and the loading time was, I would say, acceptable. In gameplay, it's absolutely fluent, but the loading time can be a little bit longer. But if you are like over the loading time, there are no problems in there. And yeah, if you have any problems with the lot, then just write it in the comments. Also, those who will or want to play the challenge have to enter the move object sheet before placing the lot. Type in bb.moveobjects and then get the lot from my gallery page and place it then. So not afterwards. That's absolutely crucial. Because if you don't do that, it will mess up the whole lot, because I stack like lots and lots of enlarged rocks and they will disappear or somehow get somewhere, I don't know, it's game logic what happens then. But that's absolutely crucial. And I also want to tell you that if you do the challenge, my lot is like not 100% safe that you, you know, can reach everything. So you also have to test that, because sometimes even with move objects, it doesn't work. So I've already tried it, but I can't make it work for some fruit trees, for example. But they are like grown on my lot and my Sims can reach them somehow. But on others, thanks again to my playtesters, it doesn't work. So there will also be some troubles, but you can, of course, change the layout or build your own island lot. Like, I don't care. But I hope that you like it, and that you like the volcano and the cave and the fishing ground and all that stuff that I put there. Rules for the challenge are down below. Download link is down below. Check out the other Sims and playtesters, of course. And that's the end of the video. I want to thank you so much for watching, and I will see you soon. Bye-bye!